Welcome to the testing world. So previously we have seen different type of test steps that we can use, or I'll say different groups of the steps which we can use while developing JMeter test script. So group was sampler, listener, assertion. So we have seen few type of groups. Now I'm going to cover remaining groups. So one is config element. So what the config element is going to do? Here, config element steps are used to perform some configurations. What does it mean? Okay, I say you want to send some data to the server, and the test data you did not set in the JMeter, you are reading it from the CSV file, or you want to read it from the notepad file. So whatever the configurations you want to make before executing your test suite, or I'll say test case, before executing your test suite or test case, whatever the task you want to perform, whatever the configurations you want to perform, that kind of configurations can be done by using config element. So reading data from CSV file before running the test case could be one configuration. So we have different type of config element which we can use for. So here we are having config element, CSV dataset config. So that is for reading the data from CSV file. In the same way, if you want to define some variables, we can use user defined variables. In the same way, we can make counter, we can add cookie manager, cache manager. So what's the use of each and every config element? We are going to understand in the coming videos. But config elements are used to make configurations before running the test case. So whatever the task you want, whatever the configurations you want to do before your test case, or I'll say before running your thread group, that will be done here in the config elements. Next is preprocessor. I'm saying preprocessor are also used for the configurations, but we are doing the same task in the config element as well. Then what's the difference between the preprocessor and config element? Main difference between the config element and the preprocessor is that preprocessor is going to execute before sampler. Means if I want to make any configuration before sending a request to the server, that can be done by using preprocessor. But if you want to make any configuration before executing your test case, you will go for the config element. Okay, I give you one more example. I'm creating a test case, or as a thread group, which have 5 samplers. So we are going to make 5 requests to the server. If I want to make any configuration before sending any request to the server, means before sending any request, if I want to make any configuration, you can go for the config element, which is running before the test case, before sending any request to the server, or I'll say before the test case. But if you want to make any configuration before any particular sampler, you can do it by the preprocessor. So preprocessor are going to execute just before sampler. Config element are going to execute before any other element, means always first the config element, then we can have different sampler. And if we have the preprocessor as well, so preprocessor is going to execute before the sampler. So I'll show you how we can use it, but as of now, preprocessors are again used for making configurations, but that is applied on a particular sampler only. Config element are going to make configuration which will apply on the complete test case. If I show you here, so we have the option of preprocessor. In the same way, we have postprocessor. Okay, I'm sending a request to the server and I got response. Once I get response and I think I want to perform some task on the response, it could be any task. I want to fetch any value from the response. I want to check any XPath over there. So postprocessor are going to execute once we get the response from the server. So whatever the task you want to perform, just we got the response from the server, that can be done by using postprocessor. So if we see preprocessor are going to execute before running the sampler, or I'll say before sending the request, postprocessor are going to execute once we got response from the server. So here we have preprocessor and postprocessor. So we have seen use of these groups as well. I'm saying post processors. So we have seen what is the use of config element, preprocessor and postprocessor. So these are the different type of groups which have a lot of steps, or I'll say elements, which we can use while developing JMeter test script. But we need to remember what is the role of each group. Like whenever I say, okay, I want to generate report, so we should automatically understand, okay, I need to use any listener. Whenever I say I want to validate something on the response, I immediately got information, okay, we want to add assertions. I want to fetch some data from the response. I'm sending a request, we are getting a response, I want to fetch some data. I'm not validating data, I'm just fetching data. So that can be done by using post-processor. I want to make some configuration. Okay, I want to set username and password. That will be used in all requests which we are sending in a test case. So because this configuration are common to all test case, I'm going to do this configuration one time. So I'll set config element that will execute before the test case, or I'll say at the start of the test case. And I say, okay, I want to set specific username and password for a particular request. Before sending the request, we want to set something for a particular request only. So we can use preprocessor for that. So now we got understanding what is the use of different type of elements which exist in different groups. So here we have seen what all the different type of groups we are having while working on JMeter. Hope you find this video informative for you. Please like this video, share this video with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel for regular updates. That's all we have. Thanks for watching this video.